them frogs.
Don't you worry about them frogs.
I hate them frogs.
Frogs and lizards, don't worry about them. I got you, girl. Shaking profusely. Actually, I was a nervous wreck. But I had to hold it all together because I wasn't going to dare let your father see me sweat.
Not tough for me to believe that you were nervous on our wedding day.
I was.
Cool and handsome as you were, when I was walking down that aisle, all I could think about was how fine you were. To myself, he is all that.
But you know what? I distinctly remember somebody's father pulling me behind that barn and saying to me, "Son, you know why a man must leave his mother and father and cleave to his own wife?" I said, "No, sir." He said, "Because if you mess up with my daughter, she'll be the last thing you'll be holding."
No, you just making that up.
No, 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 no. As much as your father loved you, what do you think he was saying to me behind that old barn? And besides, I had to make sure that I proved him wrong. He didn't make a mistake when he gave you to me.
No, baby, you certainly showed him that he had a lot of respect. He always said, "You are a man's man."
Right by you.
She didn't talk me into this and say,
that's enough for me.
You're the one.
You're the one
that told me so. That's how I know that we were meant to be. Didn't want a temporary love, not that shadow love. It just hasn't popped. No, 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 no. I wanted us to last a million years, so I had to hear from God.
You're the one, you're the one. God told me so. That's how I know.
Sandra became a devil in a she dress. y'all looking at me all funny like I look weird. I don't look weird. As far as I am, I'm telling you, Sandra and I, we had problems with sex, money, and communication.
Mark, Ann,
So, but you laying down some rules for me or something?
I have rules and you will adhere to them.
What? Rules? Bubba Daddy, you better get up real quick. And I mean real quick. I know you can see we are two very grown people, Mark. And you know what? As for your little rules, you better be saving them for your children. Oh, that's if I even give you some.
See, Sandra, it's your attitude that keeps us at a distance.
Oh, that's...
Every time we have a situation, you always throw that in my face. You know the Bible says that your body is not your own. It's supposed to belong to me.
Oh, yeah. And every time, you always throwing that scripture in my face.
You know why?
All the time.
You know why?
Why?
Because it's true. You're not supposed to be withholding from me. But you got me on rations, girl. And you talk about I don't show you no respect. But you know what?
What?
I got needs. Mm-hmm. And you better find out what my needs are. And you better find out what you're going to do to somebody.
Well, that is just it, Mark.
Right.
You don't put no affectionate moments or no affectionate. fraction of time with me, but you expect a paycheck, Mark? Please, I'll tell you what, try that junk at work. And you know what? You will quickly find out that nothing from nothing, it leaves nothing. Mm-hmm. You better make some deposits, baby, because you're in a negative.
Okay, my turn. Answer this. Who's always spending all the money around here? Who has a Sears, Dillard's, JCPenney, and a Macy's car? Girl, you got so many that if we paid them off, the national debt will be set.
You are just, really, I only use one card.
One card at a time.
And for the life of me, please explain this to me. Why is it that one woman with two small feet has over 50 pairs of shoes?
Mom, I don't even have 50 pairs of shoes. Plus, you need your woman to look good, don't you? Shoot, I need shoes to match my threads. You know a woman's gotta do what a woman's gotta do. You know what?
Oh, really?
Dress.
Really?
Yes.
I tell you what, after today, I guarantee you we won't have this problem no more.
Wait, and what is that supposed to mean? Mark. Really, Mark? What you doing? Mark. Mark, if you don't put...
Well, if you don't get
put
off
my purse down, Mark!
Get off me!
Mark!
Stop hitting me! I'll call the police on you! And guess what? A man's
no,
got
Mark,
to
no, no. You thought
what
you was
man's
on,
got
no,
to do.
No, you thought you was on rations? You just shot yourself in the foot.
Hey, I'm only trying to help our marriage get better. That's all I'm trying to do.
Oh, please. And you think that's no help? That was my only escape.
Hey, you ain't gonna get that door?
No.
Oh, because you ain't got them credit cards, them legs don't work, huh? Hey, Jay. What's up, man? What's going on? You early, man.
What's up?
Come on in here, man. Godly, what's up?
Fix those, man. Gotta make it right.
We gotta fix it. Gotta make it right.
Gotta make it right.
I tell you what, it's already fixed. But if she do it the market way, it'll be right all the time.
That's what I'm talking about, the market way. The only way.
Yeah,
it don't work that way, man. You know it don't work that way.
Man, what side you on, man?
I'm on nobody's side. But it's like this. You know, LaShawn and I, we have problems too, but we found out if we, you know, tackle those problems quickly,
right,
and then we make up. You know, that works good for us.
Hey, I'm always tackling the problem because I fix them. But that making up, Paul, that ain't working, man. That ain't working.
Yeah, I bet with your attitude, I'm sure.
Man, I promise you on that woman's side, I tell you.
Come on.
Hi, how you doing, AJ? Fine, and hi, it's LaShawn.
We came by the other day, but you know, Mark said you were shopping. I think y'all need to talk over a few things, so why don't I just go back?
No! No!
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry for hollering. Mark, we're going to settle this right here and right now. AJ, who handles the credit cards in your house? What? You or LaShawn?
Well, you know, LaShawn, she has...
Hey, forget
no,
that.
No, let him
tell me, no, no, no. Tell me this. Who handles the overspending in your house?
No, AJ. No,
no
forget that.
No.
Okay. No, forget that. Forget that. What if it's not overspending? It's not overspending. What if it's your husband? He is too cheap.
Cheap.
I'm telling you.
Cheap.
He is too cheap.
What do you know me?
I'm not with my visa.
You talk all
right. I'm sorry.
God, I think that's a lot of talk testimony.
Stop yelling.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'm so sorry.
In my house. Stop yelling.
Okay.
Everybody relax. and just talk to each other. You know, just try to respect each other.
Yeah, okay? Try.
Respect. Hey, Jay. Mm-hmm. I've been respecting this man for 4 years. But you know he's gone too far. You know he took my credit cards.
In the Bible, it says, you know, be kind to one another, you know, mm-hmm. in brotherly love, you know, honoring uh-huh. and preferring one another.
Yes, sir.
Now, I know you two, you know, you're angry right now, but I know you prefer each other because if you didn't, you wouldn't have gotten married to begin with. Now, see, right now, you're just, you know, tackling the issue of money, but, you know, from my experience, mm-hmm. LaShawn and I, we know how to handle this problem.
Hey, you know what? We know how to handle it too. But she just needs to learn how to sit down and listen to old Mark.
Now, you know what, AJ? I am not listening to Mark.
See, that's the problem.
See, I am not listening to him, but I will listen to you because you have something sensible to say. Now, talk to your friend. Talk to him right now, please.
Is that okay, Mark?
Anything the queen wants.
Well, then you.
Okay. Talking through financial difficulties is not always easy because you're always going to have difference of opinion on how it's supposed to go. Okay? Now, Mark, you know, yes, we are responsible.
Right.
But you have to remember that God has always also placed something in her. But you know, it kind of, you know, evens us out, you know, keeps us kind of balanced.
He's placed something.
Yeah, so, you know, mm-hmm. keeps us kind of balanced. Yeah, sorry. Now, you have to remember, yes, he is responsible, but, you know, you also have to remember that the difference between when he's, you know, trying to withhold something from you or when he's just trying to do a good job.
Come on.
Well, you know what? If Mark had it his way, the only time I would get a new pair of shoes is if Kmart was having a blue light special and the second one was free.
Oh,
I
no.
I didn't even shop at no Kmart.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Yes.
Girl, you know I let you shop at Learner's. Anyway, man, listen, forget that. You said there's something that God placed on the inside of her mm-hmm. that keeps us balanced.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you said?
Mm-hmm.
Man, let me tell you what the balance is between us. I go make it, and she go spit it.
And that's my job.
Man, you think God intended for it to be that way?
It's like this. I don't know what balance is for you. All I can tell you is what balance is for me.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in Psalms 3:13, uh-huh. it says, happy is the man who getteth wisdom,
mm.
and the man getteth understanding.
You're a good
friend. Now, Mark,
yeah.
I guarantee you, my brother, uh-huh. if you would just try to find out what she's passionate about, and then, you know, explore those passions with her, you'll find out why she's going on all these spending sprees.
Mark, discover me a belief.
And what's wrong with that? That's why she laughing.
Mark, do you really care?
Of course I care. You know what? I'm beginning to believe that you only go spend all the money so that you can't spend an intimate evening with me. I don't like that.
See? There you go.
What?
Interesting point. You saw the problem.
Uh-huh.
You analyzed the problem.
Uh-huh.
But you did nothing about it.
That ain't good.
AJ, do you and LaShawn vote for stuff like this?
Yes, we do. And yes, we did. Mm. But for us, talking to our financial issues was the key to us overcoming them. Yeah. Talking through financial problems is the key to stopping the devil in his tracks.
Mm, that sounds good.
Now, I don't know what, you know, what is for you two, but for me and my wife, solving our financial problems, is how we discover each other all over again.
So.
When I found you, I found somebody who cares. When I found you, found my most intimate friend. When I found you,
Sandra, that's terrible.
Mark,
up? My father would drive my mother crazy with that.
Really? Mm. Well, you know what they say. The fruit don't fall too far from the tree. Whoa, there it is.
You know, you're right, Sandra. You're absolutely right.
Okay, well, thank you, Satan.
So, how about we do this? How about we pray about it? Because there's one thing I know works. Prayer works.
Okay.
Besides, I want to communicate with you, and I need for you to communicate with me better.
Well, what do you mean? Like, is it different than what I'm doing now?
Come on, son. You act like you don't see that every time we have a situation, there's a boom! I don't want that. So why don't you come over here? Let's pray about this.
You serious?
I'm so serious.
Okay.
God, your hand's something. Okay, I'm sorry.
Check, but I had to learn how to respect him as my covering. and not do all of this. Now, Sandra, if you anything like me, and I suspect you are, sweetheart, you got to learn how to tie this up. You can't just be blowing up on a man all the time. That's not what you do. That's the difference between a wise woman who builds her house and one who tears it down.
Freak.
Let me tell you something. I love your father. I truly love him. But everyone always peaches and cream now. You know, I had to come a long way, too. I don't know how God did. Wow. But he did. Yes, he made did. A way.
Yes, he did.
Oh, my God, he made a way. He made a way. I don't know how he did, but he made a way. Standing here, not knowing how you'll get through this test, but hold on to faith, he knows best. Nothing catches him by surprise. He's got it figured out. He's watching us now. Step in.
Oh,
to say thank you because I'm sorry. I was kind of eavesdropping a little bit. Mm-hmm. I learned a lot from what y'all were talking about. Mm-hmm. I think I learned her a little better because mm-hmm. of the conversations.
Come here. Let me tell y'all something. Now, the two of y'all have something that's very beautiful. And you need to recognize its beauty, look at me, and its potential.
Yes, we do.
I know. Now, look, I gotta get back to my own husband. I'm getting on out of here, okay? Oh, wait a minute. Before yes. I go, mm-hmm. I ran out of aspirin. Mm-mm. You got any aspirin?
Baby, can you give us some aspirin?
What you looking like me like that for? I always feel good when I have me some aspirin. And your daddy too. I gotta go, y'all be good now, you hear me?
Okay, Mama, I love you. Thank
I love you,
you
too. Learn how to zip that lip.
I thought you asked me for an aspirin.
I did ask
you. You knew she was coming?
No, but I'm so glad she came.
I'm glad she came too.
No. Gosh. She got me thinking.
About what?
About the fact that there are times when I could see my childhood memories. Oh my God, and how my mama was with my daddy. She was older. I feel like coming out of me towards you. How she was with my daddy. I don't like that. And when I'm just stuck in that moment, while I'm in it, what? It's terrible. It's terrible.
What?
It's emotional. It's like this dark hole, and I'm in it, and I'm stuck, and I find myself saying things to you that I don't even want to be saying. I don't. And it's just how my mama wasn't my daddy. Every time we go there and we argue, I'm just hoping maybe it's something that you can say will rescue me.
Wow, son. That's deep. But I can dig. You know, Sandra, since we're confessing, I have a confession that I want to let you know. There's something on the inside of you. It rescues me.
What do you mean by that?
Well, you know, from the time that we met up until now, I look back over everything we've been through and you validate me. For example, remember that time we went to the conference and mm-hmm. I was sharing my business plan with everybody that was there and they just thought that my business plan was such a bad one. You believed in me.
Well, you know what? I couldn't tell because, you know, just like back then, you didn't communicate to me back then just like you don't do right now. And you know what, Mark? Yeah, I know, but even though I can tell when there is something bothering you, I never know what is bothering you, what's troubling you, or if there's anything I can even do to help you. You know why? Because you shut down, Mark. Lots of times I just feel like I'm on the outside looking.
But you know, about a year ago, I went and I had a talk with Pastor.
Wait. You went to Pastor?
Yeah, I went and I had a talk with
Pastor. Well, what did he say?
Well, I went to him and I let him know that I had some needs that I didn't know about how getting met. And, you know, he told me. He asked me a question. He said, had I told you about my needs? That's what he said. Did I tell you about my needs?
Okay, and?
And you know, I had to admit that I didn't tell you about my needs, but it was just so hard for me to admit to myself that I had all of these needs.
And then I just began to think, what happens if I tell Sandy about my needs, and then
what, baby, what?
After I tell you my needs, you make light of them, or even worse,
what?
You still reject me.
Oh, Mark, no, Mark, no.
You know, it was hard. It's hard for me to open up my heart to you, you know? But as a Christian man, I know that I got to do everything that I can do to make this marriage work. And you know, Pastor said that it's God's plan for communication to dwell in a marriage. Yeah, that's what he said.
Oh, Pastor said that.
That made me happy, too.
Wow, and yeah. You know, when I think about it, you always seem to be confident back then.
well said. Mm-hmm. Like I told you before, mm-hmm. It's all because of you. Ooh. Like I said, you validate me. You have proven to me that you are my rule. Whenever I'm with you, you make me feel 10 feet tall.
I'm so glad we had this talk because I really need to be validating you and telling you that I believe in you. I like the way you talk to me like that. I like that. I know I can do a better job at telling you how much I believe in you, and I'm gonna do better, okay? To show you the better, I'm gonna do better.
Well, you know, I just thank you for that, Sandy.
Okay.
Because there is one other area, mm-hmm. where you used to always rescue me.
Okay.
And I like to call it the ultimate rescue.
Oh, okay. Well, what is that?
Sex.
Really, Mark? Mark, really? So that's what you do? You just fill me up so you can lay me down? That's all you do, Mark? You're not telling me. All you do is talk about sex.
Oh, what else do you have to talk about?
Oh, my goodness. Mark, you see how fast you broke the mood? You always bringing up sex. Mark, I'm going to see my mama. She said, calm down. Oh, calm down. Okay, wait. Mark, why can't we just discuss the other two areas first, and then we can tackle sex?
Sandra, I believe we should tackle all three. Because sex is my frustration, too.
Well, it wouldn't be if you learned how to do the things that would get me ready for you.
Sandra, I've taken you out. Today's at the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
We went to the movies. I've even given you money. It don't seem like I can do anything to get you in the mood.
Marcus, it's not what you do that fails to get me ready for you. It's what you fail to do.
What do you mean by that?
I already told you, you don't make no deposits, but you always trying to make withdrawals.
Here you go, talking about these darn credit cards again.
Mark, although I do want my credit cards back, I am not talking about no credit cards.
Well, what do you mean by deposits then?
Fair enough, okay, well, I was watching Bishop Jakes actually yesterday. And he said that deposits are things that you can do throughout the day, throughout the week, and they're things that will make me feel special. And things that would get me emotionally ready for you. You know, you can do things like you can call me on my job and you can tell me that you're thinking about me and that you love me. Yes. And you can do a chore for me, like something that I will ordinarily do, yeah. But you know, you do it as a surprise for me.
As a
surprise.
That will
be nice. Yes, that will be nice.
Surprise? Okay, so tell me this. You remember that time that I made that bubble bath for you, girl? You remember that?
Yes, I remember.
Do you remember those candles that I had lit, girl? You remember that?
I remember that.
I bet you don't remember that Jerry Osborne I had lit in the background, girl. You remember that too?
Yeah, I remember.
So that wasn't a surprise?
Mark. Yeah, that was a big surprise.
Okay, that's what I'm saying.
But Mark, you were in the water! And all the bubbles was gone! See, Mark, that was not for me. See, that's what you call a setup. You was trying to set me up. That was not for me. That was all for you.
Sandra,
yes.
That wasn't for me. That was for us.
Mark!
No.
You don't get it, Mark.
No, no, no. See, let me explain this to you.
What, Mark?
God did not create the man for the woman.
Here we go.
He created the woman for the man.
What?
That's what he did.
What kind of statement is that, Mark? That doesn't even make any sense. Because you know, Mark, what you are saying, listen to yourself. You said that you don't care what my needs are.
I never said that I don't care what your needs are.
Mark, listen. Just like you're the only one that can tell me what your needs are, I'm the only one that can tell you about mine. Oh. And what your actions is saying is that you don't care what my needs are. You think by buying me things and taking me to some restaurant will get me in the mood for you, Mark. You don't even care that it don't. And it is obvious, it is quite obvious that you don't understand that every woman has individual needs and they're entirely different from another woman's needs. But you just do the same things for me that doesn't work. And you expect paycheck results. Mark, it doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way.
Yeah!
You better get the door.
God, man, who is this, man? Come here. Man, Grandma.
Boy, move on out of my way.
Come on.
Listen, come
here.
I am still your grandma. Hear what I say? And where is Sam?
She
in
there.
Oh, hey, Grandmama.
Hey, baby.
Oh, how you doing?
Mama.
Mama, what happened to your leg?
Oh, baby, it ain't my leg, honey. Oh. See, that man knocked his hip out a long time ago, and it ain't been right since.
Mama, didn't he know you were fragile?
Me fragile? No, baby. He was the one that was fragile. See, let me tell you. One night I told him, I said, hey, don't make no sudden moves. I got this. Honey, he tried to get creative, and the next thing I know, I heard a pop, pop, pop.
Come on, Grandma. This is another time. We don't want to hear that.
Baby, it was done. Now, I loved your granddad. Uh-huh. And when I see him in heaven, he gonna know it's me because he gonna see his work.
Girl, that is not funny.
Well, what's wrong with you, girl?
Well, Mark and I, we are having problems.
Having problems?
Yes.
Well, y'all a good couple. Then what kind of problem y'all having?
Well.
Sex?
Yeah.
What'd you say?
Yeah.
You said sex.
Sex.
Hold on, sure. Mom.
Wait,
it's too late.
No, cause see, you know what he does? He come right
Wait a minute, girl. She said y'all having problems of a sexual nature. Not us, boy. Is there something wrong with your spatula? I mean, you ain't able to flip your pancakes,
son? Now, Grandma, as much as I don't want to talk about this with you, that is not the problem.
Baby, how you think your mama got here? Honey, Grandma knows. Yeah, ooh, Grandma knows.
Step out of there.
Oh, babe, I'm sorry. Excuse me, Sharon. I was having a flashback. Now, listen. Grandma got lots of experience in this area, so tell me what the problem is, sure.
Okay, well, Mark, he comes straight home, and he walk right in the house, and then, you know, he be trying to, get busy.
Wait a minute, let me see what I understand. So he come right home.
Yes.
And just want to just
straight in the house.
Just straight right there. Yes. Like that.
Yes.
Like that. Okay,
yes,
hold on. Ma, if she say you come straight home and just get busy. That's what you're doing, son. Just coming straight home and just want to just jump right on it. Huh? That's what you're doing. That's what you doing? Ah, that's my grandbaby. That's what I'm talking about. You win. Papa girl. Now listen, is it something wrong with your skillet? Well, I'm just saying, because Grandma needs to know. Grandma needs to know.
Well, no, it's just... He is not trying to like understand like my needs. He just comes just walk right in the house. And he just always like every day
I know, baby.
Oh,
I know.
Goodness.
See, they different from us, sugar. Uh-huh, they different from us. See, we got to learn how to understand what they need, and they need to learn how to understand what our needs are. See, baby, let me tell you something, sugar. See, thank you, sugar. I appreciate that. See, a man can take one look at a woman or smell a perfume. Baby, he ready for it. Uh-huh, that's how they is. They wired like that. So it ain't just mom. All men's is like that. So we have to learn how to accept them for the way they are.
Yeah, so we just have to let them forget what our needs are, because they got needs too. And you know what? Your Mark, he always ignoring mine.
Oh, wait a minute, sure.
All the time.
Mark, come here, son. Come here.
Yes, Grandma.
You're trying to tell me that you ignoring that girl's needs and only thinking about yours. You ain't learned nothing, huh? See, my Hubbard was like that. But he learned quick, fast, and in a hurry. Because for a long time, I had his mind on rations. That's right, baby.
Hey, Grandma.
Yes.
See, that's what Cedric got me at right now. And the only thing you do is make me mad.
So you don't do no things that make me feel good.
But
I do things that make you feel
good. But listen here, baby. Let me tell you this right here. See, T.D. Jakes say that you can't be trying to get rid of something that's already there. See, because if the Lord were to take all that nature from you, sugar, you wouldn't learn nothing, see? And growth is about managing an area better. So actually, the rations thing really didn't work, sugar. So the rations thing don't work.
Somebody want to tell her that.
Please, Mark. You know what? Listen to your... I'm sorry. Listen to her. I don't need to be talking.
Wait a minute, sugar. Wait a minute. Mom, what you say?
Grandma.
Boy, if you don't get off of me... Y'all two need to get it together. Now, sit down. Oh, boy. Just sit down. Sit down. Now, listen here. Sit down, baby. Now, if y'all ain't never listened to Grandma before, y'all gonna listen to her today. Because I got experience in this area. I know what I'm talking about. You see what I'm saying? See, this the problem. Y'all frustrated. frustrating one another because you ain't listening to me.
Frustrating.
What?
I said you're frustrating one another because you ain't listening to each other.
What?
Listen. Now, Sandra.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you considered the possibility that Mark ain't just asking you for sex, baby? He just trying to throw you down. Could it be that he wants you to just show him that you need him, honey? Could that be it? Mm-hmm. And Mark? I'm over here, Mark.
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. How many ways does Sandra have to ask you to hold her?
Tell her she's beautiful. Show your appreciation for her, baby. Do you even know what ministers to her? Because you know you should. Mm-hmm. See, baby, this here is what we call in marriage the great exchange. Uh-huh. It transcends sex because anybody can have 5 minutes of fame. Or, baby, he is giving you 5 minutes. He ain't giving you 5 minutes. Mom, Speedy Gonzalez. Baby, let grandma school you. You can't run over the speed bumps. See, the speed bumps is there for a reason. See, when two people come together for the purpose of giving themselves to one another, this is what we call the ultimate beauty in the institution of marriage. See, Ma, coming together in this fashion, baby, is not limited to the physical act of sex. Because you're coming together to meet her need. But, baby, you can't fulfill a need if you don't know what her need is. Uh-huh. So as her husband, it's up to you to discover what Sandra's specific needs are and then get about the business of fulfilling them, honey. Uh-huh. That's what you got to do. Let me school you. See, baby, it's like digging for a priceless treasure. You see what I'm saying? And look. And you will be pleasantly surprised at the high fall. Stay with me. High fuck. You can go. If you just take a little extra time to explore Sandra's heart. You see what I'm saying? You got me?
You know what, Grandma?
Yes.
That just may be the best advice that I've ever heard.
Yes, baby. Thank you, baby. I got to go because talking about these bodies coming together that took me back to some memories.
Don't go back, Grandma.
Listen, baby.
Let me get that.
Precious memories.
Need you?
You know, Sam,
was so ashamed. Because after all this time, I still don't know what that means. I've been coming home, coming in the room, just looking past your knees. And for that, I'm so sorry, Sandra.
That I believed in you, and just to tell you how very much that I love you, and to show you the support that I know you deserve, and Mark, oh my God, it's true. I haven't been validating you either, and I'm sorry. What can we do?
Well, I think I know what
to breathe.
for today. Sorry that we went through all the things that we went through. Please forgive me, please.
I do. I mean, when I think about how easy, you know, I could have just been supporting your dreams and aspirations, but I feared. And I didn't even consider that you needed me to be there for you in that way. So every time you brought up your goal, I dashed it down with fear and unbelief. So it's okay. No wonder you resented me and just only talked about sex.
It's all right. It's all right.
Well, Mark.
Yes.
You have done a wonderful job at loving me and nurturing me today. Goodness. And you know, I was thinking.
What's that?
I was thinking that maybe I can love and nurture on you tonight. but Mark, I mean, I feel uncomfortable coming to you like this. It's just, I don't know, but. Okay, no, here it is. Okay, every time I ask you for aspirin, that's gonna let you know I'm in the mood. And then. It's like my way of initiating. I don't know. It's always been that like that in my family. It's like a Robert's woman thing.
Wait. Hold on. You mean to tell me your mama didn't have a headache?
She said she needed aspirin. She never said she had no headache. So, Mark.
What's that?
I need you to come. Get me some aspirin so we
you
can...
You need me to get you some aspirin?
Yes.
Oh, on my own then, girl. Well, you know, audience, you've all seen and you learned my secret as to how I began to love Sandra with the pure love, the agape. Yep, on that day, I took everything in. And every day since, I've been putting forth 100% towards our marriage. It hasn't been easy. It hasn't been perfect. But this has been the perfect relationship for me. We work very hard, day after day, to tackle the issue of sex, money, and communication. I'm so very proud of the outcome of our marriage. And if Sandy's father was here, he would be so very proud as well.
Mr. Brother Walter Brooks.